This is the Tech Phantom, and welcome to episode 9 of this Dark Souls easy mode walkthrough. We are trying to make the game as easy as possible, or at least to minimize some of the risks and to minimize some of the stress that new players face when they take on some of the tougher areas in Dark Souls. So, in this episode, we are going to be going through an area that gives a lot of people fits. I know that it was very, very difficult and stressful for me in my first playthrough, and that is Anor Londo. And there is a sizable and very apparent increase in the level of the enemies. The enemies in Anor Londo are tougher, and they require better skills. Some of them require some pairing skills, especially if you are playing with the melee character. But thankfully, with our sorcerer character, we can continue to use the same tactics and strategies that we have used so far, and that is to try to stay at length and utilize our spells, which do quite a bit of damage, to take out the enemies quickly and safely as much as we can. Okay, so you saw me go down an elevator and take out a gargoyle, and that gargoyle can drop his equipment. And we proceeded up the beam and through this broken window, and there are a couple of painting guardians that are guarding this area. And this painting guardian dodged our homing soul mass, but that's okay. We can take him out with the lightning spear. The painting guardians don't have any poise. Their equipment doesn't have any poise, so a single hit from a melee weapon will stun them. And if you have a weapon that does enough damage and enough endurance, you can attack them repeatedly and you can take them out with a melee attack, again, because they don't have any poise and they will stun quickly. But on these beams, the easiest way to take out the painting guardian is with a melee attack, and a lot of people like to use bows. But number one, we don't have a bow, and number two, I really don't like bows, guys. If you've seen other playthroughs in my channel, you know that I hardly use any bows. And I shouldn't say that I don't like bows. I just don't use them. I've actually thought of doing a ranger playthrough just to get over my, I don't want to say fear or distaste, but just to see what the ranger playthrough is all about. And actually, in the comments, let me know if that's something you might be interested in seeing, a playthrough of Dark Souls using a ranger character, where I would only use bows and crossbows. And that's definitely going to be out of my comfort zone, because I have very, very rarely used bows. Alright, so we took out the painting guardians with homing soul mass, and we are going to trip this lever. And by swinging it counterclockwise, it will go down. It's a left-handed screw, if you're trying to figure out which way the lever will make the stairs go. And when we do that, we are accosted by another gargoyle. Now, for some reason, I always think that this gargoyle is harder than the first gargoyle. I don't know why, but maybe because of the crowder area where you fight them. And I don't know if this gargoyle actually has more vitality or does more damage, but I always seem to have a little bit more of a challenge with the second gargoyle than the first gargoyle. Of course, this being the easy mode walkthrough, we had absolutely no problems whatsoever taking out the second gargoyle when we use homing soul mass. And you saw that he did drop the gargoyle halberd. And we don't have a lot of strength, so The Gargoyle Halberd is going to be one of the few weapons that are going to be available to us to do quite a bit of damage. And the Gargoyle Halberd is an outstanding weapon. As a matter of fact, if you want to see how I ranked it relative to other weapons, check out the video in my channel that's the top 10 best weapons in Dark Souls. And there are two versions. There is one version that's about a year and a half old. It's obsolete. So check out the newer video, which has a more up-to-date list. Okay, so you saw me go up to the handle again and push the stairs down even further, and that is going to allow me to reach the Dark Moon Tomb bonfire. And the reason I like to come here is so that I can activate this bonfire as a warp point for later use, for later fast travel into this location. Now, I'm gonna go back to the bonfire in Anor Londo. So in order to do that, there's going to be a little bit of backtracking here. I'm going to have to push up the stairs. So this time I'm going to make them go clockwise. And again, this is a left-handed screw, so if you want something to go down, it's counterclockwise. If you want something to go up, it's clockwise. I know that it's not very intuitive, but I like to remember. It helps me remember when I think of it as a left-handed screw as opposed to a standard right-handed screw. And the difference between a left-handed screw and a right-handed screw, for those of you that don't know what I'm talking about, a right-handed screw, if you take your right hand and you naturally move it from left to right, a right-handed screw would go down when you make that motion. A left-handed screw, when you make the natural motion of twisting your hand from left to right, I'm sorry, from right to left, which would be counterclockwise, that would be the natural motion of the left hand, a left-handed screw would advance and would go down. So that's a little bit of an explanation for you. I hope that made sense to you, and I hope that helps when you're trying to figure out which way to put this, to push the lever for the staircases. Alright, so I was talking about the Anor Londo bonfire. I went back and I rested there for a couple of different reasons. First of all, there are some items that these guardians, that these sentinels are guarding. And these are actually, again, these are the normal sentinels. There are going to be some larger versions of the sentinels that we will meet. And their shields block an absolute 100% damage of melee damage, and they also block pyromancies and miracles and sorceries. So they're a little bit difficult up close. They also swing around with their halberds, and they have quite a large attack area. But you saw that with Soul Spear, by stepping back and by aiming away from their shield, it just took one hit, and we were able to finish them very quickly. All right, so we are going to take on this mimic here. And he is going to drop a crystal halberd, which, again, this is a weapon that doesn't have very high requirements. I believe the requirements are 16 strength and 12 dexterity, the same requirements as the Gargoyle's halberd. So that's a good weapon for low dexterity, low strength builds. Halberds in general, other than the Black Knight halberd, have low requirements but have the highest amount of attack rating relative to their weight. So they're very, very good weapons for builds that don't have a lot of strength and dexterity but still want to do quite a bit of physical damage. And the Gargoyle Halberd in particular, it's one of the better weapons in the game, and it's the strongest weapon in the game from a weight standpoint when used as an elemental weapon, if you make it into either a fire or a lightning version of itself. Alright, so we are going to the other sort of chapel, the other area, and we killed a couple of the sentinels, and we did that because we wanted to level, to have enough souls to level up. And again, you know, one of the ways to reduce the stress of walking around in Dark Souls is to not have as many souls on yourself. That way, if you lose the souls, you're not so stressed about trying to get to your bloodstain and recover the soul. So we were able to level up, and you saw that that leveling consumed most of the souls that I had in my inventory, and I only have 1,106 souls. So if I happen to die, it's really not going to matter if I can't make it back to the bloodstain and pick up my souls. Okay, so you saw me put on the Darkwood Grain Ring. And again, this ring will allow you to do a cool animation that the community refers to as the ninja flip. But it, when you do the ninja flip, you advance further and faster than if you would, as opposed to just rolling. And not only that, but the ninja flip animation has a longer invincibility window or more invincibility frames, so it makes it a little bit easier to dodge attacks. And we are going to be going through a very difficult section, especially if you've never been through it, and the Darkwood Grain Ring is going to allow us to just roll by these opponents or flip by these opponents. Now you could also take them out, but that's going to consume my spells and it's going to take a little bit longer time, so I just I prefer to just roll with the Darkwood Grain Ring by these opponents, and as long as my timing is correct, I should be good. Alright, so we're coming up to a very difficult section. There is a door, the way to proceed is guarded by two archers. And the archers have very, very large bows, and the arrows are very, very strong. And one hit from the arrows could push you off the beam and could knock you out. So this is a little bit of a difficult section, and here I make a very, very dumb mistake. I just essentially fell off. I didn't walk all the way up to the past the beam up into that little ledge by the wall, and I just essentially fell off. So that was a very dumb death. But again, we only had 100 or 1,106 souls at play, so it's not that big of a deal. So let's try this again. So normally, in order to get past the last archer, you would have to get up to him and you would have to melee him. And you can probably the easiest thing, the fastest way to go about getting past that archer is to do a parry and riposte with a strong weapon or while you're wearing the Hornet Ring and to take him out. But as a sorcerer, we have a second option, and that's to use Homing Soul Mass. So I'm actually going to put Power Within. I don't know if I even need it at this point, because Homing Soul Mass is probably strong enough, but just in case, I'm going to use Power Within and along with Homing Soul Mass. And when I see an arrow coming at me, I'm just going to flip past it. And Homing Soul Mass took out the archer for me. So how easy is that, guys? Talk about easy mode right there. That is about the easiest and one of the safest methods to get past the archers. And again, we took advantage of Power Within, Homing Soul Mass, and we also took advantage of the additional dodging ability we get from the Darkwood Grain Ring. Alright, so we come up to the bonfire inside of the Anor-Londo Castle, and we are going to do some exploring. There are a couple of shortcuts that can be opened here, but what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to pick up some items that I think are useful. Now, I parried this guy, and parrying the Silver Knights is a good thing to learn. But again, you don't have to parry them. You don't have to parry them. What you can do is you can hold up your shield and circle them. Sometimes it takes a little bit of time, but eventually you will get to their back, and you can backstab them a couple of times with the lightning spear, and that'll do it. All right, so I broke through a little bit of an illusory wall that was inside of the chimney. and I find these chests. Now I know that that chest is that of a mimic because the chain is sort of straight and broken. So we're gonna take out this mimic. And this mimic is going to drop an occult club, which actually has very, very low requirements, and we would be able to use it. It's a weapon that does magic type damage, or I guess divine type damage. And I guess the mimic was guarding these four chests that have Havel's equipment, his armor, his shield, and his weapon. And the Havel armor has very high strength, but it also has the highest, it will give you the highest poise that you can get in the game when you wear it. So it's a good item to have. Alright, so now we're going to go up this spiral staircase. And we see another chest, and again, this is a mimic, and we can tell because of how the chain is shaped. And again, we're going to take him out with Homing Soul Mass. And these mimics have a chance to drop the symbol of Avarice, which is a headpiece that looks just like they do. And when you wear it, it will increase your drop rate to the highest possible in the game. But while you have it on, it will also decrease your life, sort of similar to being poisoned or having cast a power within. And there also drop some coins, which you can feed to Frampt in a Firelink Shrine for some additional souls. And there is going to be a Silver Knight here, a spear-wielding Silver Knight, guarding a soul of a hero. And we are going to take him out with Homing Soul Mass. And their equipment is a little bit more magic resistance. You could tell because it took a couple of hits to take them out. And from here, there is a sniping spot where you can take out this Titanite demon or this prowling demon. And this guy is pretty tough, especially if we were to fight him inside of that little room there, because there's not a lot of space to maneuver. But it's pretty easy to kite him up here, either with a bow or with Soul Spear and with Great Soul Arrow. And he gives us 5,000 souls. And he is also going to drop some Demon Titanite, so let's go get it. All right, so there's a little bit of a shortcut. You can actually jump over the railing and land on that walkway. You have to align the camera properly, and you have to make sure that you get a running start so you get the jumping animation when you hit the roll button. And there it is. And here is the room where I fought, where the prowling demon was. And we are going to pick up the Demon Titanite. And now we are going to open up a shortcut back to the bonfire where we rested. And it's guarded by another Silver Knight. So again, we're going to use our Homing Soul Mass. Now that time, Homing Soul Mass hit his shield, and his shield has a little bit of magic resistance. And actually, the Silver Knight shield, I think it's the best shield in the game. It's certainly the best light shield in the game, or the best shield you can parry with in the game, the best standard shield. It's a rare drop from these guys, but it's actually worth the farming because it has very, very high stability, and it has good elemental resistances as well. Alright, so I was out of Homing Soul Masses, so I just used my Lightning Spear to backstab him. And there's going to be another Silver Knight off to my right, and he's guarding a couple of chests. That actually holds their equipment, the Silver Knight armor, so I don't need it at this point. So we're just going to ignore it. And we've opened up the shortcut back to the bonfire. So this is the bonfire where we started. Alright, so we have enough souls to level up. So we are going to level up. Let's see if I do strength or intelligence. And I continue to level up intelligence. And again, guys, you will see why in a couple of videos. But if you're following along, you may want to mix in some endurance. You don't have to, but it could make things a little bit easier down the line. Alright, now also this is easy mode. And we have the ability to kindle bonfires up to 20. So why not do it? Why not have 20 Estus flasks? And I especially like to do that because we're going to be going into a boss fight. So I'm going to go ahead and kindle this bonfire. Now the boss fight that's coming up is marks roughly the halfway point in the game, and some people think that it is the toughest boss fight in the game. It certainly, I would agree with them, it certainly was the toughest boss fight in the game until the DLC came out. I think that the Arcturia's boss fight is about on par with Smorin Ornstein, and the Mana's boss fight is also pretty tough. But the boss fight in this area, the reason why it's difficult is because you have to fight two bosses at the same time. And after you take out one boss, the other one will become a supercharged version of itself and will steal what remains of his comrade's power, and he will grow in stature and power, and then you have to take out the second boss. And again, like I said, this is typically considered one of the toughest boss fights in the game. Let's see how we do with easy mode. So the quickest way to the fog gate is to make that little jump again from the spiral case onto the walkway. And here we are in the main center part of the castle. And we get a message that the black eye is quivering, is telling us that the murderer of Anastasia is nearby. So we will take on the murderer of Anastasia in a later video. And here we go, guys. Here we go with the Smo and Ornstein boss fight. And that's Smo. And he is susceptible to lightning. And that's Ornstein, and he is susceptible to fire. So that's another thing that makes this boss fight difficult, is that one boss is susceptible to one type of damage, while the other one is susceptible to a different type of damage. So if you've selected either a magic weapon or a fire weapon, you'll have an easy time with one boss, but a little bit more difficult time with the other boss. So the strategy that I'm following is to keep them both in my sights, in front of me. I'm going to take out Ornstein first. And you saw he went down really, really quickly with Soul Spear. And I put on the Darkwood Grain Ring to give me the ability to dodge their attacks. And after Ornstein is done, you see Smol uses whatever remained of his life power and becomes a supercharged version of himself. And his most, he has two attacks that are very dangerous. That's one where he puts his hammer in front of him and he charges you, and at the end he will swing it. So you want to make sure that you're as far out of range as you can. And the other attack, which is dangerous, especially because we don't have a lot of vitality, is when he jumps up into the air and does a butt slam and releases an AoE lightning attack. So the strategy very simply here is to cast Homing Soul Mass, get to his right a little bit so the hammer doesn't block the attacks, and just simply take him out. So there's the attack I'm talking about, the butt slam. And it looks like another hit or a couple of hits will do it, so I'm just waiting for an opportunity to hit him with Homing Soul Mass, and I'm trying to stay as far away from him as I can. It takes a little bit of time to cast Homing Soul Mass, so I'm going to wait till he's far along. And that's it, guys. That is the Small and Ornstein fight with the Sorcerer in easy mode, and that is about as stress-free and as easy as I can make it. So that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. This is the Tech Phantom signing off.